want y'all to help me love on my sister, Pastor Christina Robinson. Hallelujah. And I got another sister. I want y'all to help me love on my sister, Minister Kathy McCleary. And I am yours truly, LaShonda Brown, yes. Prophet and Congregational Leader of the Sanctuary International. Yes. Hallelujah.
I began to pray about what he wanted me to say concerning the introduction of this gathering. And what the Lord began to deal with me was that we have not come to a place of effectiveness simply because we have not truly encountered God. Yes. Every man of God, everyone that has been effective in the Word of God had an encounter with God. They had an encounter. Abraham had an encounter with God, allowed him to worship him. Moses had an encounter with God. Hallelujah. Paul had an encounter with God. And every time they had an encounter with God, Jacob wrestled with God. He had an encounter with God. And because he had an encounter with God, because they had an encounter with God, God allowed them to move mightily and they were able to be effective. We as the church who can no longer attend service but never have an encounter with God. I don't know about, does anybody have come here for an encounter tonight? Yes. I feel the Holy Ghost right here. We have to encounter God. Yes. No more church as usual, but an encounter. We need God to invade our space. Because when we have God invade our space is no longer our space. Oh, amen. There's one particular text in John chapter 4, very familiar passage of scripture, with the woman at the well. She too had an encounter. And because she had an encounter, Christ was able to present to her the true blueprint of worship because of her encounter with God. The Bible says that Jesus came to Samaria. When you understand the context of John chapter 4, Jesus traveled from Judea up to Galilee. And in context, usually any Jew would avoid going to Samaria because to go through that place would mark them as unclean. But how many know that God went out of his way? I wish I could talk right there. God went out of his way just to meet this one young lady so that she can have an encounter and to discover the blueprint of worship. Could I tell you today that Jesus Christ, God himself, came in the form of human flesh and went out of his way just so that you can have an encounter with him. I wish I had ministered to the whole church right there. How many know God went out of his way just so that you can have an encounter so that you can worship him? Yes. Jesus went out of his way, went from Judea to the eastern side of the Jordan River up to Galilee. But while he sent everybody else off, he made it his business to go find this woman at the well. It's interesting that in John chapter 3, Nicodemus, the religious man, came and found him. Yes. But in John chapter 4, Jesus went to find the sinner. Oh my God. I wish I could talk about to y'all right there that deliverance can come. Yes. That God went out of his way not to go find folk who thought they had it together, but to find folk who need him. Oh my God. He traveled down to Samaria. He found this woman. And in their dialogue, he began to ask her for something to drink. And it's interesting that we're always looking from a natural eye when God is trying to minister to our spirits. Are y'all hearing me? while Jesus is trying to offer her a spiritual glass of something to drink, all she can do is see in the natural. Amen. And until you really encounter God, everything that you do when it comes to ministry will operate in the natural until you really understand what it takes to worship God and begin to see things in the spirit. And so we are gathered here tonight because Jesus desires to meet us, not at the well, but at the sanctuary tonight. He desired to meet us here because he no longer wants us to see things in the natural. See, it has to start somewhere. If 12 men could mobilize and change the face of this world, then what happens when the remnant of believers get together and truly encounter God and carry the oil from tonight back to where they are? Yes. Am I talking to a church full of believers here tonight? Jesus ministered to her, and even in the midst of her sin, he still gave her the encounter of her life. And in their dialogue, she says to him, "You are a Jew, and you worship at the temple in one mountain. I am a Samaritan, and I worship God in the Mount of Gerizim. But in this season right now, here, right now, it's not about being at the sanctuary. It's not about being at your home church. It's not about wherever you worship at. But God is calling for true worshipers. That whether your pastor is there, whether your apostle is there, whether your bishop is there, God is calling for true worshipers that can worship him in spirit and in truth. And not based on where I am, but my relationship. The encounter that I had with the Messiah. That when he saw me, when he touched me, when he changed me, I was able to worship him for real. For real. I didn't have to be in a particular location because I understand that my worship is not based on my location. It's based on where he resides. The true vehicle of worship is to worship in spirit and in truth. Well, he says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." If you cannot know Jesus personally, if you cannot have an encounter with Jesus personally, you can never have a worship experience.
We watch and we wait, Lord, we anticipate the moment you choose to appear. We worship, we praise until there's no debate, and we recognize you're already here. Thank you. Praise unto you.